There you're recording.
It works.
All right.
But also, it actually has kind of like a steel punching glove. It's sick. So, what I do in battle, here's my enemy, I probably punch for the sternum. Now, if I break the sternum, the ribs are going to collapse, probably lacerate as long as I'm lucky. If not, he'll have his heart started by his own brick. So, I'm sorry, troll. Now, another way one can use this is to use the ring. You look closely, the ring is raised, which thickens it, reinforces it. And what I can do with this ring is really nasty. If I aim for the bridge of the nose, that will actually create a deep dent in the skull. And basically, you'll find the bridge of the nose. We'll go from here to the back of the brain. So pretty much your face is folded in two. So it collapses the skull. Battle in the older days. Not so civilized. Although I don't think any war is truly civilized, is it?
You guys here to see a sword fight? See them talk.
Yeah.
does an annual spring fundraiser, and this is what we're doing this year. And if you were here in the last couple hours, we had a riot doing fun things like face painting and sword fighting with a pirate, and we had a jail here, and people were put in jail and had their pictures taken, and all kinds of fun stuff. All of this is a riot. Love it. But it's actually for a purpose too, because this is a fundraiser, and I brought along my close friend Christina Nancy. She is the coordinator of our post-adoption services program. She's going to take a minute or two to explain what we do at Bethany with post-adoption services. So listen real carefully, because I don't have the microphone, but Christina's going to explain that.
Ah! No!